Hello friends and hello students. My name is Ashok Sijala. In this session is addition of two 1D array in C language. So addition operation means summation. So simple two integer we have to sum. So why we cannot sum of two 1D array? Yes, so that is also possible. So let us check. I first fix my screen here so you can watch my better way video lecture, and here Turbo C++ is there. I just selected, double click and take some process, and now just open. And here Alter F file menu and taking new file. And here our goal, write a program to enter two TW, two one dimensional array, okay, arrays. And you can say that perform, not find. So perform addition, okay. So yes, addition or summation, we can say that operation or simple addition, okay. So yes, so that is my always technique. What is a input to your definition find? So two 1D array we have to scan from user and then process. So what is a, that is a addition or summation, we can say that, and then output. So that is a like output to our addition operation. So input, output, and in between process. So logic means process means logic. So that is a very simple definitions, but if you not know, so I just perform this definition to you. So here on your standard input output and console input output, and then main, and that is my technique. First we can input one dimensional array as a perfect way and then perform to other operations. So first I take only one and then clear screen, yes, and then shootable message to our, because that is a one dimensional array. So enter 1D one dimensional array elements, that word, that value known as element, and here provide the slash n. So in out for loop we have to, that is a one for loop for one dimensional array, and that is a declaration, data type, array name, and that subscript, that known as subscript, and bracket means that subscript and file. So array other name is a subscript variable. So here integer that we have already define I. So I is zero because index is start with always zero, and I less than five and I plus plus, and there is my technique with scanning with index and printing with index always. So we can look better how the value is stored in our 1D array, one dimensional array. So here we can provide I. I is our index. So and scan a function. So we can first scan percentage d and ampersand x of I. Okay. So yes, that is scanning complete. And then I copy this part because no wasting time. So here we can print, and I here get ch. And first I save this file. F2 is a shortcut key. So array 1D. So A1D and addition operation. So addition dot c. So we can find out. Here some addition operation is there, or we can say that summation, both word use, so addition or summation. So here we can remove, enter is not, we can say that 1D array elements are, so that is a here how its element. And here we can only single statement in for loop, so I remove this brace, and here we can remove this scanf function. And yes, here I comma, and here I give second percentage d, okay, and also remove this brace. All are well. So save, and let us any error is or change is required. So I compile. Yes, there is no error. So A1D array means array one dimensional array, and addition dot exe file is generated. Okay, and I run. So let us. So that is my technique. X of I, so we can say that our store value, that is index one, zero means position one, and index two, one, then two, three, I give sequence. Yes, so that print horizontal. So that is a sometimes student. Yes, if you not some only scanning time like index. So you can just remove this I, and sometime demanding like I give the one blank. So that is a just first I take printing part perfectly. So I give again same value. So that is a 1, 2, 5. Yes. So that is also printing. And if you scanning time not looking good for index, then also you can remove. But we can understand the how that index is value store in array. Okay. So array is a very important concept. Array and pointer is a very powerful tools of C language. Okay, so we in my technique, I always print the index and scanning and printing time. So here I give again index that is look better. Yes, sir. Here is not here. And here I provide the slash n. Okay, so here I just remove because there are two times. Here is a okay. Now, yes, let us run again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, that complete perfectly. Scan and print is 1 1D array is complete 1, but here our definition enter 2 1D array. So again I declare the second 1D array, and that is give y name and same size 5, and then same I copy this part scanning and printing also I copy all, and let us copy and paste and change to our x to y. So here we can first our message we can change enter x. Yes, here give x 1D array. Yes, so prefix is a x, so we can find it is a x, and then here in between that 1D array is print. So first we can scan and then print all. Okay, so I remove this printing part to cut, and here after that yes here. So all well. Now first we can scan to our 2 1D array. So here enter y, yes, and messages, and here change the y, and here we'll change the y. Yes, all are well. And then here we can say that prefix I capital x 1D array, and here that is x is perfectly, and now here I capital y, yes, that element, and here we can change to x to y. Okay, so very simple way edit. Yes, so all are well. So let us check 2 1D array scan and printing. Yes, so just first is x, enter x 1D array, so we can find the x. I give sequence first. Yes, that second, so I give s continue 6 7 8 9 and 10. So yes, so yes, that message is only not perfect, but all our value and printing is perfectly 1 2 5 x and 6 to 10, that is y. Okay, so only our second message of y, that is provide one new line. Yes, so where is there here? So here we can provide to slash n, so that give the message, and now our that input and that is our input and output is perfectly input and out, but output we can also addition, but now turn to our main that logic part. So what to do, we can take other z variable. Yes, z 1D array, and then taking the sum, the sum of 2 1D array. So here we can provide in between that scanning part. Here I take again for loop, and then start I equal to 0, same I less than 5, and I plus plus. And here we can take yes, there is anything more required because only one statement is there. Z of I equal to x of I plus addition operation. Then y of I, so that is a summation, and now after last we have to print the z value. So again I copy this part next and paste, and here we can say that here or last you can only print z, that is also good. Z 1D array element r, we can say that with addition, or no problem, you cannot provide that with addition means addition x and y. So here we can also take like z, we can normal our integer variable. So here we can give equal sign x plus y, that is only message for our reference. Okay, so addition operation. So here we can change to y to z. Yes, only change here require z. Yes, now that complete our logic. So there is very simple logic, only one for loop, and our addition is completed. Yes, x that what happened, x of z of I, x of I and y of I, that addition in z of I, that is loop is continuous. So all element is some element by element, that summation. So let us check how it's. So I give first sequentially, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yes, and reverse order. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So yes, addition is a that is a 5 plus 1, 6, and 4 plus 2, 6. So all are well. So I give the testing, so we can easily addition operation look it the better way. So all are 6 because that 5 plus 1, 6, 4 plus 2, that 6, 3 and 3 plus 6 and 4, 2, 6 and 5, 1, that is reverse order. So and that is a simplicity, we can give the same reverse order. You can give any element, there is no problem. I give run again, and here I take a randomly element, so 1 and 8, 5, 4, and give any value. And now in I check like in different value. So here not value I can give, so we can 3 is not, yes, 1 to 10 I give, so 4 is there, 7 is not there, yes, and 9 is not there, yes, and then 5 is not there, and 4 is there, 1 is there, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, so only remaining 10, okay. So yes, so now let us look. So our X 1 and then Y first 0, 3, so 4, yes, 4. Then 8 and 7, 15, yes, 15. 6 plus 9, so also again 15. And 4 plus 5, so 9. And 2 plus 10, so 12. So that is a very simple logic. So in this program, I think not required in press watch window. So very simple. And only one required to work in this session, that is a my technique, if that is a static element, here we can initially give some big size and then we can take one n variable. Okay? So we can scan to user. So user can chance to give maximum 50, but that is not required, but we can give more size and enter 1D, yes, one dimensional array size. So we can scan our n variable number of size, and you can also use size variable, but here we cannot use n, yes. And here static 5 I remove the n variable, all loops here 5, yes, and all loop I provide the n, so we can control our loop. That is not dynamic array, that malloc calloc I always give that statement, okay, in my video lecture. So malloc, that is memory location, that is a static array, that is okay. Just control to ourselves. Like we can, here I give the 3 size. So all array, like I give again 1, 2, 3 and give any value like 7 and 8. So that is summation. Yes, look, 1, 6, that 7, 2 plus 7, 9 and 3 plus 8, 11. So that is control to our loop. So here we can chance to run this program and take different type of value. So not only 5, that is a meaning. So here I give testing 5, we have to now enter, but now I give the 6, so there are 2 1D arrays. So I give randomly, 6 is there, now second. So I again give randomly, yes, any value. So give some small value. So yes, look, 1 plus 7, 8, then 9 plus 5, that is 14, and 4 plus 4, know what, 3 number, okay, so 6 and 4, that 10, yes, and then 3, and that is a, which value is there, we can, yes, 3 index and 3, so that is a 4 and 7, 3, 7, yes, and last 4 index 3 and 8, so 11 and 5, means last element, 5 plus 8, 10, yes, but that's not visible, I again open. So yes, 2 plus 6, yes, last is a not 8, but 6 in Y, so that is 8, so that is complete. So that is a meaning of this session. So you can chance to enter any n size, so we can up to 50, but we cannot testing that number of time, but just you have to also, you can give the, so big size here, we can also up to here 20, 50 to 20, so that is not, that declare the compiler to that number of allocation of memory. So that is a declaration. So we can control some our loop. Okay. So now I complete. Yes, this write this program addition of two 1D array in C language. I complete and close this file. Any doubt of this definition? Yes, you can comment line in my video lecture in YouTube channel. I close this file and quit. So subscribe my channel Ashok Sejal Academy. Press the bell icon to never miss any update. And thanks for your watching, supporting, and sharing my video lecture. And Hare Krishna.